The Lies of the Third Temple, Part 49. I'm Professor Hannes Redlinghuis of the First Assembly of Yafashua, South Africa, Pretoria, Montana, also international. Should you require any of the books which I've written, I'm thinking about Israel's rapture, where just one third of Israel in the Great Tribulation, which will be called the Remnant of Israel, or the elect, will be saved by the preaching of the 144,000 of Revelation 14, which is from the 12 tribes of Judah, from Jacob. It's a thick book. It's actually part of my PhD degree, Israel's Rapture for Israel. The book is called Israel's Rapture. Should you require any information or any other books, it's a WhatsApp number, +27 international for South Africa. The number is 0722-367-124, or just go to my website, https://yahvah.co.za. If this is the first time that you will participate in the study, you're very, very welcome. But before you can participate in the study, I need you to go and start with part one. Why? Because you've missed a massive lot of information that you need to know. Otherwise, the things that I will be saying now won't make much sense to you. Alright. You also need to subscribe in order to receive the notification of all the other studies that we are currently busy with. It's very important to have a pen, at least a 1611 King James Bible, and a writing pad ready to make your notes. Welcome to Breakfast with Prof Hannes. I trust that this study will be a blessing unto you in the name of Yafashua. Hallelujah. We will continue where we left off yesterday morning. Now I'm just going to back to verse 8, 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 8. But let us who are of the day be sober, the bride, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for an helmet, the hope of salvation. Why does the helmet? Because it's got to cover my soul's dimension, from my eyebrows to the top of my head. Verse 9, for Yahweh hath not appointed us to wrath. Who? The bride. We're not appearing before a white throne judgment. It's what he says there. For Yahweh hath not appointed us, the bride, the Yafis, to wrath, but to obtain salvation by Yafashua, our Redeemer and our Savior. We are saved by the blood. There's no white throne judgment. Can you see that? He says, who died for us. Now, I just want to read verse 9. For Yahweh hath not appointed us the bride to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Yafashua, our Redeemer and your Savior, who died for us. So why won't we appear before white throne judgment? Because Yafashua has died for us. He gave us salvation. That whether we are awake or asleep, who are they? We are the bride. We are the Yafis. Whether we go to bed to sleep or whether we awake, we should live together with him. Now that him, small letter H, make it a big letter H. You can't refer to Yahweh, Shua, and put a him, small letter. He died for us, that whether we are awake or asleep, we should live together with him. When we live out of this world with him. So with other words, he's not coming for the bride like a thief in the night. Wherefore comfort yourself together, and effray one another, even as also you do. In other words, preach the truth. Don't be led by your nose, by church dogma and teachings. Do your own research. And we beseech you, brethren. So who is he talking to? He's talking to the bride, brethren and sisters. And beseech you, brethren, to know that which labor among you and are over you in Yahweh, and abominish you and to esteem them every high in love for their work's sake, and be at peace among yourself. The bride must live peacefully among ourselves. So I want to ask a question. Is he coming for the bride like a thief in the night? No. Is he coming for the drunkard and the sinners like a thief in the night? Yes. He says in verse 14, now we exhort you, brother, warn that you are unruly, comfort the feeble and minded, supporting the weak by patience toward all men. So we need to be evangelizing the world. So what do? We need to live in holiness. Why? Because Yahweh has a plan for us. Everyone. He says in verse 30, see there are no more, none render evil for evil unto any man, but even follow that which is good, both among yourself and to all men. That is the bride of Yahushua. We need to live in holiness. Rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing. In everything give thanks. For this is the will of Yahweh in Yahushua concerning you. So with other words, quench not the spirit. Be alive. Do not be so, subjected to sin and the teachings of church dogmas. Despise not prophesying. Provide all things, hold fast that which is good. Abstain from all appearances of evil. With others, withstand Satan, and he shall flee from you. Who? The bride. Why? So in order not that we should be overtaken and be overwhelmed like a thief in the night. And that every Yahweh of peace sanctifying you holy. And I pray, Yahweh, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blamelessly unto the coming of Yahushua, our Redeemer. He says what? He's praying that our be preserved blamelessly. We shall be in holiness. And that's why after we've been immersed in the water grave and we arise, we've now put on the wedding garment. Galatians 3 verse 26 to 29 says, those who are immersed in Yahushua has put on Yahushua. It's the wedding garment. But that's not where it stops. Now it's the rest of my life. I need to live in holiness every day of my life, keeping my wedding garment clean. Be preserved blamelessness unto the coming of Yahushua. Faithful is he that cometh you, calleth you, and also will do it. Brethren, pray for us. Greet all the brethren with us, a holy kiss. I charge you by Yahweh that this epistle be read unto all the holy brethren. It what? I had to read this rest to come to all of it, to come to the back, to the last part. I charge you by Yahweh our Elim that this epistle, 1 Thessalonians 5, be read unto all the holy brethren. Is he coming for the holy brethren like a thief in the night? Has the church lied to us? I can't hear. Has the church lied to us? The grace of Yahushua be with you. The grace. The blood of Yahushua. The grace of Yahushua be with you. Whose are they? Are these drunkards? No. These are the bride of Yahushua. I don't ever want you to let anybody in your life again tell you that he will come upon you like a thief in the night. You must take this scripture, this chapter, and you write it in your Bible. Write it in your Bible. If anybody ever just mentions something like a thief in the night, Then you must stand on your feet and say, this is not scriptural that you are preaching. He's coming for the drunkards and the sinners like a thief in the night. Verse 2 says, he's for the thief in the night like a drunkard and the sinners. Verse 4 says, you brethren know, he will not come like a thief in the night. So now we understand that the Bible is not contradicting itself. It is actually enforcing itself, confirming itself. Now we will now, with the information that we have about 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, we will now continue with Matthew 24 verse 37. You will remember we stopped at verse 36, and then I said I'm going to take you through the scripture of 1 Thessalonians 5, and we went through that with now understanding he's not coming for the bride like a thief in the night, but he will come to the sinners like a thief in the night, and to Israel, the nation of Israel, the two-thirds that will not accept him as the Messiah and Savior. Now, the question is, who is Yahushua speaking to in Matthew 24? He was speaking to his 12 disciples, who were Hebrew men, who were Israelites. He spoke to them. So what he explained in Matthew 24, up to this stage, it's got nothing to do with the bride of Yahushua. It's all refracting to the great tribulation at the end of time, after this final covenant has been broken by the Roman Catholic Pope, which will reveal himself as the Antichrist. That you will find if you study the revelation of the book Revelation. But again, start with part one, the revelation of the book Revelation. Now it says in Matthew 24 verse 37. He says, but as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. So he's going to come. He says, as in the day of Noah. When Noah were building the ship, the people didn't believe him. I just want to share. Did you know that unto that stage that Noah was start building the ark? The people, from the start of creation up to Noah, never saw one drop of rain. There's not a scripture in the Bible that says there were rain till the day that Noah went into the ark and the doors were sealed by the Ruach HaKodesh. That's when he was talking about the water flood that will come from heaven and the earth is going to be flooded and everybody's going to be drowned. People did not understand what he was talking about, because the earth was wetted by the dew in the mornings and the mist. That's how the earth was wet. That's how the plants grew. The plants of that time. There were not one drop of rain fell till the day that Noah went into the ark and Father sealed the door through the Ruach HaKodesh. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also be the coming of the Son of Man. For who? For Israel. For as in the days they were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark. And then everything changed. Actually, the whole nature changed. Because the moment that they went into the ark and the door was sealed, nature had to change in order for the clouds to gather water and rain to be able to be formed, to fall on the earth and to flood the earth. Now I know there's some theologians that says, no, it wasn't the whole earth that was flooded, it was only a little area where Noah was, and the Bible says the earth was flooded. Everything on the earth drowned. If the Bible says everything, then it's everything. It's like that's the same New Ages today that says that hell is not for eternity. Hell is for a short period of time. Then somebody's going to close the gas and the fire will go out. No, no, no. My Bible says that heaven is for eternity. It's forever and ever. Now, if heaven is for eternity, then hell is going to be for eternity. And if on some stage there's going to be an end to hell, then on some stage there must be an end to heaven also then. You understand what I'm saying? I'm just drawing the two parallels. So when the Bible says that the whole earth was flooded, it means the whole earth was flooded. We either believe the Bible. 1 Corinthians 11 says that the faith is by the hearing, and the hearing is by the word of Yahweh. So we either understand and we believe the word, or we reject the word and live as sinners. Now, I'm just going to stop here until tomorrow morning, if it's Father's will. And then we're going to continue. Go and read Matthew 24, verse 38 and further on. Maranatha. Yahshua is coming back again. Hallelujah.